Akash, and today we will see a trip about Purana Kila. It is located near the New Delhi Zoo at Mathura Road. And now you are seeing a Google map description about Purana Kila, the images and the reviews by the tourist of that place. And it opens at 7 a.m. and closes at 5 p.m. It's a big fort, and it has three main locations inside to visit, such as Bada Darwaza, Sher Mandal, Humayu Darwaza, and Talaki Darwaza. And you will take around 2 hours minimum to complete the whole area, to walk around it and read the description. This Google map allows you to see how big the area is and how you can move around the location, the pathway, and the greenery of that area. Also, now you will see how to reach Purana Kila from metro station. The nearby metro station is Khan Market, which is 2 kilometers of distance. An auto will charge you 50 to 60 rupees to this location from the metro station, and it will take around 10 to 15 minutes depending on the time you visit and the local traffic you get. And now you will see the ASI site from where you can book your tickets online. It is advised to book your tickets online before visiting the place, as it will save you time. And if it's a rush day, you might have to wait in the line. So to avoid that, please book online and select your time, like early morning or post 12 p.m. And this ASI will tell you, selecting your nationality, about how much the website charges you. So just select your nationality and give details, your name and your details of your ID card, and then you are good to go. Pay through Paytm or any UPI mode online. Purana Kila is one of the oldest fort in Delhi, India. It is located near the expansive Pragati Maidan exhibition ground and is separated from Dhyan Chand Stadium by the Mathura Road, Delhi. History: pre-Islamic origins and Indraprastha theory. Excavation points to traces from the 3rd century BC, the pre-Mauryan period. The first two rounds of excavation in 1954 to 1955 and 1969 to 1972 by B.B. Lal, then Director of Archaeological Survey of India, ASI, had unearthed traces of painted grey ware culture. Historian Alexander Cunningham identified the fort with that of Indraprastha, though he referred to present structure as built by Muslim. Din Panha. Purana Kila is said to be fort of ancient Indian city of Indraprastha, where the legendary Pandavas ruled. The origin of Purana Kila lie in the walls of Din Panha, the new city of Delhi, being constructed by Mughal Emperor Humayun in the general Vindh city of ancient Indraprastha ruins. Abul Fazl states that he built the fort in the place of that of ancient Indraprastha. The founder of Suri dynasty, Sher Shah Suri, defeated Humayun and made his changes to the fort, strengthening its fortification and completing its walls. He also had another fort built there called Shergarh, where the governor resided. His project, however, was a continuation of Humayun's construction of a citadel for a royal city. He also built many structures inside the fort. Additions to the fort have been believed to have been made even after his rule. The extent of his contribution to the fort construction is disputed. The historical attribution of its construction is also uncertain. Judging from primary sources, Mohammad Khwadamir said that Humayun laid the foundation of the city on a mountain near Yamuna. The construction of the walls and the fortifications were also finished by Humayun's time. Tariq-e-Daud states that Sher Shah Suri royal city remained incomplete upon his death, and he had named his fort Shergarh. Abbas Sarwani states the two forts being constructed by him were incomplete when he died. Tariq-e-Khan Jahan states that Salim Shah Suri had constructed a wall defending Din Panha of Humayun. Purana Qila and its environs flourished as the sixth city of Delhi. On 7th October 1556, Hindu king Hemchandra Vikramaditya, who had defeated Akbar's forces decisively at Battle of Delhi 1556, was crowned in Purana Qila. British era. Edwin Lutyens, who designed the new capital of British India, New Delhi, in 1920, had aligned the central vista, now Rajpath, with Purana Qila. During the partition of India in August 1947, the Purana Qila, also with the neighboring Humayun tomb, became the site for refuge camp for Muslims migrating to newly founded Pakistan. This included over 12,000 government employees who had opted for service in Pakistan, and between 150,000 to 2 lakh Muslim refugees who swarmed inside Purana Qila by September 1947, when Indian government took over the management of the two camps. The Purana Qila camp remained functional until early 1948, as the trains to Pakistan waited until October 1947 to start. World War II. During the Asian Pacific War 1941 to 1945, over 2,000 Japanese civilians were interned in British India, of whom around 554 were women and 224 children. Plans to intern Japanese living in British India, along with the surveillance of persons of interest, were put into place from as early as July 1940, with a preparation to open internment camps made from at least February 1941. After war broke out between Japanese and Allies later that year, Japanese civilians in India, along with those of other non-enemy nations, were joined in internment by civilians from various British colonial territories.
including Malaya and Singapore. Two key civilian internment camps in India were Purana Qila, the Old Fort in Delhi, Deoli in deserts of Rajasthan. The fate of Japanese in India threw a shadow over the whole business, and the British believed with some justification that the ill treatment of Allied prisoners of war was a reprisal for this. Two key civilian internment camps in India were Purana Qila, the Old Fort in Delhi, and Deoli in the deserts of Rajasthan. The fate of Japanese in India threw a shadow over the whole business, and the British believed with some justification that the ill treatment of Allied prisoners of war was a reprisal for this. By December 1942, there were 2,115 Japanese internees, the vast majority from Singapore, in Purana Qila camp outside Delhi. They were housed in tents that gave little protection from the cold in the winter or from the temperature that rose to 120 degrees in summer. The Japanese government protested that the food and the cooking, washing and sanitation facilities were inadequate. The British dismissed this. The Japanese were notoriously unable to cope with the extreme of heat or cold. Treatment of Japanese internees in India, 1st December 1942. According to Asiatic standards, officials observed that rations were adequate for proper nourishment. R. N. Gilchrist to Under Secretary of State, Foreign Office, 19 October 1942. IABIT. Recent years, in 1970, the ramparts of Purana Qila were used as the backdrop for theatre when three productions of National School of Drama were staged here: Tughlaq, Andha Yug, Sultan Razia, directed by Ibrahim Al-Qazi. In later decades, it has been the venue of various important theatre productions, cultural events, and concert. Today it is the venue of daily sound and light presentation after sunset of history of seven cities of Delhi from Indraprastha through New Delhi. Excavation. Archaeological Survey of India carried out excavation at Purana Qila in 1954 to 1955 and again from 1969 to 1973 by B.B. Lal, and in 2013 to 2014, 2017 and 2018 by Vasant Kumar Swarnakar. Its findings and artifacts are exhibited at Archaeological Museum, Purana Qila. These include painted grey ware dating 1000 BC and various objects and pottery signifying continuous habitation from Mauryan to Shunga, Kushna Gupta, Rajput, Delhi Sultanate and Mughal periods. The homes built during the Rajput era were built of bricks used in other structures and also mud bricks. A fortification wall about 30 meter long was also found during this. Delhi Sultanate structures were made from reused bricks and over the ruins of earlier structure. The Mughal era structures were characterized by a deep pit dug over those of the preceding eras. Physical features. The walls of the fort rise to a height of 18 meters, traverse about 1.5 kilometers and have three arched gateway. Bada Darwaza, Big Gate, facing west, which is still in use today. The South Gate, also popular known as Humayun Gate, probably also known as because it was constructed by Humayun, or perhaps because Humayun tomb is visible from there. And lastly, Talaki Gate, often known as the Forbidden Gate. All the gates are double-storied, sandstone structures flanked by two huge semicircular bastions tower decorated with white and colored marble inlays and blue tiles. They are replete with detailing, including ornate overhanging balconies or jharokas, and are topped by pillared pavilion chhatris, all features that are reminiscent of Rajasthani architecture as seen in the north and south gates, and which were amply repeated in future Mughal architecture. Despite the grandeur of exterior, few of the interior structures have been survived except the Qila-e-Kuhana Mosque and Sher Mandal, both credited to Sher Shah.
Qila-e-Kuhana Mosque. The single domed Qila-e-Kuhana Mosque built by Sher Shah in 1541 is an excellent example of pre-Mughal design and an early example of extensive use of pointed arch in region, as seen in five doorways with true horseshoe-shaped arches. It was designed as Jami Mosque or Friday Mosque for the Sultan and his courtiers. The prayer hall inside the single aisled mosque measures 51.20 meters by 14.90 meters and has five elegant arched prayer niches or mihrab set in western wall, marble in shades of red, white, slate is used for mihrab set in western wall. Marble in shades of red, white and slate is used for calligraphic inscription on central ivan mark, a translation from Lodi to Mughal architecture. At one time, the courtyard had shallow tank with a fountain. A second story accessed through staircase from the prayer hall with a narrow passage running along rectangular hall provided space for female courtiers to pray, while the arched doorways on the left wall, framed by ornate jharokas, was reserved for members of royal family. On a marble slab within the mosque, an inscription reads, "As long as there are people on the earth, may the edifice from frequented and people be happy and cheerful in it." Today it is best preserved building in Purana Qila. Sher Mandal. The Sher Mandal, named for Farid Sher Shah, who had tried to finish what was ordered by Babur but had died during the initial phase of so construction, was halted until the arrival of Humayun. This double-storied octagonal tower of red sandstone with steep stairs leading up to the roof was intended to be higher than existing height. Its original builder was Babur, who ordered the construction and was used as a personal observatory and library for his son Humayun. Finished only after he recaptured the fort, it is also one of the first observatory of Delhi, the earliest being in Pir Ghalib at Hindu Rao at Ridge, built in 14th century by Firoz Shah Tughlaq. The tower is topped by an octagonal chhatri supported by eight pillars and decorated with white marble in typical Mughal style. Inside there are remnants of decorative plaster work and traces of stone shelves where presumably the emperor books were placed. This was also the spot where on 24 January 1556 Humayun fell from the second floor to his death. He slipped while hastening to the evening prayers, following his hobby of astronomical stargazing at the top of this private observatory. He fell headlong down the stairs and died of his injuries 2 days later. Entry inside the library is now prohibited.
Outlying monuments. Several other monuments lie around the complex, like Kirul Manzil, mosque built by Maham Agna, Akbar's foster mother, and which was later used as Madarsa. Sher Shah Suri Gate of Lal Darwaza, which was a southern gate to Shergarh, also lies opposite to the Purana Kila complex across Mathura Road, southeast of Kirul Manzil. Timings of this place is from 7 a.m. to 5 p.m.
Thank you. Purana Kila is one of the oldest fort in Delhi, India. It is located near the expansive Pragati Maidan exhibition ground and is separated from Dhyan Chand Stadium by the Mathura Road, Delhi. History: Pre-Islamic origins and Indraprastha theory. Excavation points to traces from the 3rd century BC, the pre-Mauryan period. The first two rounds of excavation in 1954 to 1955 and 1969 to 1972 by B.B. Lal, then Director of Archaeological Survey of India, ASI, had unearthed traces of painted grey ware culture. Historian Alexander Cunningham identified the fort with that of Indraprastha though he referred to present structure as built by Muslim. Din Panha. Purana Kila is said to be fort of ancient Indian city of Indraprastha where the legendary Pandavas ruled. The origin of Purana Kila lie in the walls of Din Panha, the new city of Delhi being constructed by Mughal Emperor Humayun. In the general winds city of ancient Indraprastha ruins, Abul Faisal states that he built the fort in the place of that of ancient Indraprastha. The founder of Suri dynasty, Sher Shah Suri, defeated Humayun and made his changes to the fort, strengthening its fortification and completing its walls. He also had another fort built there called Shergarh, where the governor resided. His project, however, was a continuation of Humayun's construction of a citadel for a royal city. He also built many structures inside the fort. Additions to the fort have been believed to have been made even after his rule. The extent of his contribution to the fort construction is disputed. The historical attribution of its construction is also uncertain. Judging from primary sources, Mohammad Khwadamir said that Humayun laid the foundation of the city on a mountain near Yamuna. The construction of the walls and the fortifications were also finished by Humayun's time. Tariq-e-Daud states that Sher Shah Suri royal city remained incomplete upon his death and he had named his fort Shergarh. Abbas Sarwani states the two forts being constructed by him were incomplete when he died. Tariq-e-Khan Jahan states that Salim Shah Suri had constructed a wall defending Din Panha of Humayun. Purana Kila and its environs flourished as the sixth city of Delhi. On 7th October 1556, Hindu king Hemchandra Vikramaditya, who had defeated Akbar's forces decisively at Battle of Delhi 1556, was crowned in Purana Kila. British era. Edwin Lutyens, who designed the new capital of British India, New Delhi, in 1920 had aligned the central vista, now Rajpath, with Purana Kila. During the partition of India in August 1947, the Purana Kila, also with the neighboring Humayun Tomb, became the site for refuge camp for Muslims migrating to newly founded Pakistan
This included over 12,000 government employees who had opted for service in Pakistan, and between 1,50,000 to 2,00,000 Muslim refugees who swarmed inside Purana Qila by September 1947, when Indian government took over the management of the two camps. The Purana Qila camp remained functional until early 1948, as the trains to Pakistan waited until October 1947 to start. World War II. During the Asian Pacific War, 1941 to 1945, over 2,000 Japanese civilians were interned in British India, of whom around 554 were women and 224 children. Plans to intern Japanese living in British India, along with the surveillance of persons of interest, were put into place from as early as July 1940, with a preparation to open internment camps made from at least February 1941. After war broke out between Japanese and Allies later that year, Japanese civilians in India, along with those of other non-enemy nations, were joined in internment by civilians from various British colonial territories, including Malaya and Singapore. Two key civilian internment camps in India were Purana Qila, the Old Fort in Delhi, Deoli in deserts of Rajasthan. The fate of Japanese in India threw a shadow over the whole business, and the British believed, with some justification, that the ill treatment of Allied prisoners of war was a reprisal for this. Two key civilian internment camps in India were Purana Qila, the Old Fort in Delhi, and Deoli in the deserts of Rajasthan. The fate of Japanese in India threw a shadow over the whole business, and the British believed, with some justification, that the ill treatment of Allied prisoners of war was a reprisal for this. By December 1942, there were 2,115 Japanese internees, the vast majority from Singapore, in Purana Qila camp outside Delhi. They were housed in tents that gave little protection from the cold in the winter or from the temperature that rose to 120 degrees in summer. The Japanese government protested that the food and the cooking, washing and sanitation facilities were inadequate. The British dismissed this. The Japanese were notoriously unable to cope with the extreme of heat or cold. Treatment of Japanese internees in India, 1st December 1942. According to Asiatic standards, officials observed that rations were adequate for proper nourishment. R. N. Gilchrist to Under Secretary of State, Foreign Office, 19 October 1942. IABET. Recent years, in 1970, the ramparts of Purana Qila were used as the backdrop for theatre when three productions of National School of Drama were staged here: Tughlaq, Andha Yug, Sultan Razia, directed by Ibrahim Al-Qazi. In later decades, it has been the venue of various important theatre productions, cultural events and concert. Today it is the venue of daily sound and light presentation after sunset of history of seven cities of Delhi, from Indraprastha through New Delhi. Excavation. Archaeological Survey of India carried out excavation at Purana Qila in 1954 to 1955 and again from 1969 to 1973 by B.B. Lal, and in 2013 to 2014, 2017 and 2018 by Vasant Kumar Swarnakar. Its findings and artifacts are exhibited at Archaeological Museum, Purana Kila. These include painted grey ware dating 1000 BC and various objects and pottery signifying continuous habitation from Mauryan to Shunga, Kushna Gupta, Rajput, Delhi Sultanate and Mughal periods. The homes built during the Rajput era were built of bricks used in other structures and also mud bricks. A fortification wall about 30 meters long was also found during this. Delhi Sultanate structures were made from reused bricks and over the ruins of earlier structure. The Mughal era structures were characterized by a deep pit dug over those of the preceding eras. Physical features. The walls of the fort rise to a height of 18 meters, traverse about 1.5 kilometers and have three arched gateway, Bada Darwaza, Big Gate, facing west, which is still in use today. The South Gate, also popular known as Humayun Gate, probably also known as because it was constructed by Humayun, or perhaps because Humayun tomb is visible from there. And lastly, Talaki Gate, often known as the Forbidden Gate. All the gates are double-storied sandstone structures flanked by two huge semicircular bastions tower decorated with white and colored marble inlays and blue tiles. They are replete with detailing including ornate overhanging balconies or jharokas and are topped by pillared pavilion chhatris, all features that are reminiscent of Rajasthani architecture as seen in the north and south gates, and which were amply repeated in future Mughal architecture. Despite the grandeur of exterior, few of the interior structures have been survived except the Qila-e-Kuhana Mosque and Sher Mandal, both credited to Sher Shah. Qila-e-Kuhana Mosque. The single dome Qila-e-Kuhana Mosque built by Sher Shah in 1541 is an excellent example of pre-Mughal design and an early example of extensive use of pointed arch in region as seen in five doorways with true horseshoe-shaped arches. It was designed as Jami Mosque or Friday Mosque for the Sultan and his courtiers. The prayer hall inside the single Esselt Mosque measure 51.20 meters by 14.90 meters and has five elegant arched prayer niches or mihrab set in western wall, marble in shades of red, white, slate is used for mihrab set in western wall. Marble in shades of red, white and slate is used for calligraphic inscription on central Ivan mark, a translation from Lodi to Mughal architecture. At one time, the courtyard had shallow tank with a fountain. A second story accessed through staircase from the prayer hall with a narrow passage running along rectangular hall provided space for female courtiers to pray, while the arched doorways on the left wall framed by ornate jharokas was reserved for members of royal family. On a marble slab within the mosque, an inscription reads, "As long as there are people on the earth, may the edifice from frequented and people be happy and cheerful in it." Today it is best preserved building in Purana Kila. Sher Mandal. The Sher Mandal, named for Farid Sher Shah, who had tried to finish what was ordered by Babur but had died during the initial phase of so construction, was halted until the arrival of Humayun. This double-storied octagonal tower of red sandstone with steep stairs leading up to the roof was intended to be higher than existing height. Its original builder was Babur, who ordered the construction and was used as a personal observatory and library for his son Humayun. Finished only after he recaptured the fort, it is also one of the first observatory of Delhi, the earliest being in Pir Ghalib at Hindu Rao at Ridge, built in 14th century by Firoz Shah Tughlaq. The tower is topped by an octagonal chhatri supported by 8 pillars and decorated with white marble in typical Mughal style. Inside there are remnants of decorative plaster work and traces of stone shelves where presumably the emperor books were placed. This was also the spot where on 24 January 1556, Humayun fell from the second floor to his death. He slipped while hastening to the evening prayers, following his hobby of astronomical stargazing at the top of this private observatory. He fell headlong down the stairs and died of his injuries 2 days later. Entry inside the library is now prohibited.
Outlying monuments. Several other monuments
lie around the complex, like Kirul Manzil, mosque built by Maham Agna, Akbar's foster mother, and which was later used as Madarsa. Sher Shah Suri Gate of Lal Darwaza, which was a southern gate to Shergarh, also lies opposite to the Purana Kila complex across Mathura Road, southeast of Kirul Manzil. Timings of this place is from 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.